Caffeine bad for your heart? Our nutritionist and author of this book, Secrets for a Healthy Diet, Monica Reinagle, is here with a coffee quiz to help us sort out fact from fiction. Good morning.
Good morning.
Well, okay, so we have a lot of questions about coffee. A lot of us obviously think it helps keep us awake. So you have a true and false quiz we're going to go over. All right, first question. Coffee protects against Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. I didn't know that. Is this true or false?
That's true. You know, coffee not only stimulates the nervous system, it appears to protect it. And people who drink coffee regularly have a significantly lower risk of Alzheimer's and Parkinson's disease. That's pretty good news.
Okay, so it's warding off disease. Coffee protects against, is coffee bad for your heart? Is that true?
Coffee's gotten a little bit of a bad rap on this. It's actually false. The reality is coffee doesn't increase your blood pressure, it doesn't cause heart attacks or arrhythmias, and most importantly, people who drink coffee have no increased risk of heart disease or heart attack compared with people who don't.
So
you don't need to worry about
it.
It doesn't, no.
Okay, well, hey, that's good to know. Coffee makes you a better driver. Really? Is that true?
Well, now, if you've had a couple of drinks, having a cup of coffee is not going to make you safe behind the wheel. But assuming you're sober, coffee does improve your alertness, your vigilance, speeds up your reaction times, and that can make you a safer driver.
I'm going to have a question for you after we're done with this. Coffee drinkers need less sleep.
What do you think?
No way.
You're right. You know, coffee does make you feel more awake, even if you haven't had enough sleep, but it does not reduce your body's physiological need for sleep. And you will pay the price for that sleep debt, even if you're compensating with caffeine. So it's still important to get enough sleep.
Okay, so following with that, drinking coffee can improve your mental performance. I believe that.
That is true. Yeah, it's obviously not going to make you any smarter, but it does help you focus and concentrate, and it can also improve your memory and your recall. So you may perform better on tests, for example, and other cognitive tasks with the benefit of a cup of coffee.
Or on air.
That's right.
Decaf is a healthier option, true or false?
What do you think?
I would say true.
Well, if you're sensitive to caffeine, obviously it would be a better option. But actually, a lot of the benefits that you get from drinking coffee are from the caffeine itself. And in fact, I didn't know this. Caffeine is actually a powerful antioxidant.
Didn't know that either.
Yeah. Well, in fact, because we drink so much coffee, researchers estimate that it may be one of the more significant sources of antioxidants in many people's diets.
So the question, speaking of dieting, is can it improve your workout?
Yes. In fact, up until recently, the International Olympic Committee banned caffeine as a performance-enhancing drug.
Wow.
But unlike most performance-enhancing drugs, this one's safe for you to try at home. You can have a cup of coffee about an hour before your workout, and you may be able to go just a little bit harder, a little bit longer.
If you have a headache, coffee can relieve a headache.
Have you ever tried that?
Well, I've had headaches because I haven't had my coffee.
Ah, that's another question.
That's another issue? Okay.
But one of the things that caffeine does is it constricts the blood vessels, and this can relieve a headache. It also makes other pain relievers like aspirin or Tylenol up to 40% more effective, and that's why you'll often see caffeine in headache remedies.
So do you want to drink coffee with your Tylenol?
You can, but you want to watch out if you're taking something like Excedrin that already has the caffeine in it. You want to make sure you're not doubling up by mistake.
I've noticed that too. If you've had a couple of drinks and you take Excedrin the night before you go to bed, it keeps you up a little bit.
Oh dear.
Not that I've ever done that. Okay, coffee is addictive. I believe that.
Well, this is half true. Technically speaking, you know, in the strictest sense of the word, it's not addictive. But if you drink coffee regularly, you'll become habituated to the caffeine, and if you stop, you may end up with a little bit of a headache
for a couple of days.
In fact, doctors have realized that a lot of post-operative headaches are actually due to caffeine withdrawal. So if you you can do yourself a favor. If you have a procedure coming up, try to wean yourself off the caffeine gradually over the course of a week or so, and then that'll be one less thing you have to deal with.
Who knew? Drinking coffee has no health risks.
Well, this one's actually false. Although there are a lot of benefits to drinking coffee, it's not completely without risk. Pregnant women are advised to avoid it because it can lead to lower birth weights. If you have heartburn or reflux, it can make those symptoms worse. And of course, for any of us, too much caffeine can leave you jittery and can disrupt your sleep. So you want to enjoy it in moderation.
Do you drink coffee?
I do.
Me too. Okay, you have a great book. You have a book signing coming up real quickly. Where's your book signing?
Tuesday at 5:30 in the afternoon at Limbricks in Belvedere Square. I'm going to be answering questions about nutrition and having a book signing.
And you have everything in here, from what sweetener to put in your stuff to the type of butter to use. I mean, you cover it all.
I tried to answer everybody's questions about nutrition.
All right, Monica, thank you so much for joining us. We certainly appreciate it. And good information. Who knew some of this stuff? This is great.